Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see how the filter can be designed. So we will follow some kind of procedure to design a filter. So we will see what is the procedure which is to be followed to design a filter, and depending on the procedure we are going to solve one problem so that you will understand how the designing can be done for the filter. So before we go for the designing of a filter, let's see what is the procedure. So design procedure of a filter. So here we are going to see the procedure for designing a first order Butterworth low pass filter. As I said, if there is only one pair of a resistance and capacitor, then it is known as a first order filter. So first job is to calculate the cut off frequency. Now if resistor and capacitor value is given, if you remember the diagram for a low pass filter, for a non-inverting terminal, we connect resistor and capacitor in this way. If this R and C value is given, your first job is to calculate the cutoff frequency, because cutoff frequency can be decided over the values of RC. Second, select a value of a capacitor, usually between 0.001 microfaraday and 0.1 microfaraday. So these are the standard value which we use for a filter designing. So if you go for any kind of filter, any type of a filter, whether it is a first order, whether it is a second order, the capacitor which we use in a network is always have the value between 0.001 microfaraday to 0.1 faraday. Now here you have a capacitor value. Then third, calculate the value of R. If the value of capacitor and resistor is not given, then you have to assume the value of capacitor, and you are supposed to calculate the value of R if cutoff frequency is given. See, it will be vice versa. If the cutoff frequency is given, you are supposed to find out the value of resistance, and if resistance and capacitor value is given, you are supposed to find out the value of cutoff frequency. Then once you get the value of R, that you will get from the equation FC, that is the formula of cutoff frequency is 1 divided by 2 pi RC. So according to the values given from this particular formula, you can calculate one of which is not given. Then fourth, select the values of R1 and RF. Now R1 is an input resistance which is connected to the inverting terminal, and RF is a feedback resistance which is connected between the inverting terminal and the output voltage which provides you the feedback. So this will decide the gain of an amplifier. But we know that for a low pass Butterworth filter, we have a non-inverting configuration. So closed loop gain of non-inverting configuration is AVF is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. So this R1 and RF depends on the desired value of a passband gain. Now if this gain is given as equal to 2, so if it is given as 2, your RF should be equal to R1. Then only you will get the value is equal to RF is equal to RF, so you will get the gain is equal to 2. Now if you have AVF is given is equal to 3, then you should have this particular parameter value is equal to 2, then you will get the total gain is equal to 3. So get this, you need to have RF should be equal to twice of R1. So when you substitute, you will get 1 plus twice of R1 divided by R1. So you will get the gain is equal to 3. That is how you are supposed to decide the value of R1 and RF to get that particular gain. So now depending on this procedure given, we will solve one problem which is based on low pass filter design. Let's read the problem. Problem is, design a first order low pass filter for following specification. So in specification it is given that passband voltage gain is equal to 2. And second given as cutoff frequency FC is equal to 10 kilohertz. As I said, either they will give you the value of cutoff frequency or they will give the value of R and C. So if cutoff frequency is given, you are supposed to find out value of resistance. Now the cutoff frequency is given. I can assume the value of capacitor. So let's assume capacitor is equal to 0.01 microfaraday. Now I have the value of capacitor, I have the value of cutoff frequency. I can use the formula of cutoff frequency, which is equal to FC is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi RC. Now here I need to find out R, so I will take R over here. So R will be equal to 1 divided by 2 pi into C into FC, which is cutoff frequency. So here I can elaborate 2 pi into capacitor value is 0.001 microfaraday. FC is given 10 kilohertz. So 10 into 10 raised to 3. Here you can write instead of microfaraday, it will be into 10 raised to minus 6. If you calculate this value, you will get resistance value will equal to 15.91 into 10 raised to 3. So here we have the value of a resistor. So I have the resistor capacitor network for the low pass filtering. So now I have got the value of resistor, that is 15.91 kilo ohm. And see, I have assumed that 0.001 microfaraday. Correct. Now my job is to find out the value of R1 and value of feedback resistor RF. Now let's see, the AVF is given as a 2. Passband voltage gain is equal to 2. Now we have, this is a non-inverting configuration. So for a non-inverting configuration, my value of closed loop gain is equal to 1 plus RF upon R1. Since I want AVF is equal to 2, I'll substitute 2 over here. You can see RF by R1, you will get 1. So RF by R1 is equal to 1. That means your RF should be equal to R1. That means they both should have the same value. So you can assume any value resistor for RF. Here I have assumed 1K. You can assume 10K, 10 kilo ohm. You can assume 11 kilo ohm, like that. So here is the final designing circuit. I have find out the value of a resistor, that is a 15.9 kilo ohm, which is given to the non-inverting terminal. I have assumed the capacitor value 0.001 microfaraday, and this two resistors, that is a feedback resistor and input resistors, are having the same value, that is 1 kilo ohm. So this is the final design circuit for the low pass Butterworth filter. And since we are using only one pair, it is known as a first order Butterworth low pass filter. I hope you have understood what procedure you need to follow for the designing of a low pass filter, and you have understood the problem which we have solved. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida. Do subscribe eKida. Thank you so much.